Good morning, I'm Brenna, and today I want to share with you SpaFlow, an XFlow pipeline for single-cell phenotyping and spatial omics. And SpaFlow also happens to be my very first NextFlow pipeline. And so I'll also be sharing a little bit about my experiences and perspectives as a first-time NextFlow developer, and hopefully by the end, convince some fellow beginners that you really can do it too. Okay, so a little intro on spatial biology. Spatial biology allows us to understand the spatial context of single-cell biomarker expression. So not only can we tell which biomarkers a cell is expressing, we can also tell where it is in the tissue and which neighboring cells it might be interacting with. So the specific type of spatial omics data that SpaFlow works with is called multiplex immunofluorescence, or MXIF. So this technology uses fluorescent antibody probes to quantify protein expression, and we can mix and match those probes into custom panel designs so that investigators can focus on the phenotypes and cellular functions that are most important to them. So I have an example of an MXIF image here. We can see three of the probes. So the white would be the nuclear marker, the blue would be a tumor marker, and the yellow is a T cell marker. So in this instance, we might be looking into how immune cells can infiltrate into tumors, hopefully interacting with and hopefully killing those tumor cells so that we can have better outcomes for patients. That's just one application of many. So I'll talk about the overall process of MXIF analysis and where SpaFlow fits in here. So we start with the images that come off the microscope with all of our fluorescent channels. And then the next step is to segment the cells. So this just means we're taking cell membrane-specific markers and determining where the boundaries of each cell is in the image. And once we know which pixels belong to which cells, we can quantify the fluorescence and therefore the protein expression profile of each cell. So then this is where SpaFlow comes in. Once we know the expression profile of every cell, we can find the phenotypes of those cells. And there are a multitude of different ways to achieve this. Two major categories would be supervised methods and unsupervised methods. And SpaFlow is a tool for the unsupervised clustering method of phenotyping in MXIF. So I'll go into the steps of that on the next slide. But once we know the phenotype of every cell in the image, we can run all of the fun spatial analysis, looking at specific neighborhoods and how those cells might potentially be interacting. Okay. So, as I mentioned, SpaFlow works on unsupervised clustering of MXIF data. So there are a few steps here as well. We start out with the quantified protein matrix. So we have every cell in the image and then every marker that we want to use for clustering. And then we run a couple QC steps. So here we're basically determining which cells might be artifacts and which cells have potentially dissociated from the rest of the tissue so that they would be not unhelpful for our spatial analysis. They've lost their spatial context. And then we perform the actual clustering step. And this is very similar to a single-cell RNA-seq, where we just do a dimension reduction, run community detection, and then we look at the expression profile of each of those clusters to assign them their phenotypes. And we feed those results into downstream analysis, so we can do visualization, hypothesis testing, neighborhood testing, and all that fun stuff. Okay, so how I was running this analysis in the past was a series of R Markdown scripts that I was customizing for every single project. I was running them locally, just in a loop. It took a long time. It was not parallelized. There was manual intervention at every single step where I was setting off individual loops for every step. And it was really just going to be unsustainable for the sizes of data sets that we're starting to see with this technology. So we're used to, in the past, we've been working with data sets of a few hundred thousand cells, and there are new platforms that are coming out doing whole slide images, and the data set can be upwards of 10 million cells. So obviously this was not going to work in the long term. And what we needed was a solution that would be fast, scalable, work on different types of infrastructure. So we have a Slurm cluster, and then we also are moving into the cloud. And we obviously wanted to add reproducibility to our work. And as the cherry on top, we wanted to be able to combine languages because there are many, many different packages that can do this type of clustering analysis. And we wanted to be able to leverage as many as possible. So of course, I wouldn't be here if Nextflow hadn't been the answer to all of those problems. Which brings me to SpaFlow itself. So there are three main phases, the quality control phase, the primary clustering steps, and then the post-clustering analysis. We start out with those CSV files of the protein quantification matrix, and we have one of those for every image in the data set, and those will all be run in parallel. And then we have a few configurations that go in for the QC cutoffs and the clustering parameters. And so those will go into our QC step, and we'll just run those QC metrics that I talked about before and generate a set of HTML reports that can be reviewed by investigators to determine the quality of the data from each image. And then we're also producing a set of CSVs, one for every image, that has the cleaned cells. And those move into the primary clustering step. And this is the most exciting step for me, because previously, with the inefficient way that I was doing things before, I really only had the bandwidth to run one package, use one language, and I couldn't be very flexible. But with the flexibility that Nextflow gave us, we were able to add two additional packages. So we can now run three clustering and phenotyping algorithms, two in R and one in Python. And so each one of those generates an HTML report that we can use to look at the expression profiles of the clusters and determine those phenotypes, and a set of CSVs that has the coordinates of every cell in every image mapped back to its cluster assignment. And those mapping coordinates files can then move into either the spatial analysis, or they also move into our post-clustering processes. And we have a couple of these processes that basically compare the different packages, and you can mix and match, use one, two, or all of them. And then there's also a step that we do that's a cluster of clusters step. So we just generate a common set of clusters across all of the images in the data set. Each of those, again, generates a set of HTML reports, and the meta-clustering step generates another mapping file of the coordinates to those common set of clusters. So this has really sped up and allowed us to scale up. It's been a big success for us, so here's a bit of our performance results. We have, through the power of parallelization and automation, reduced our runtime on our HPC cluster by over a factor of 10. We've run data sets of up to 850,000 cells in under 30 minutes. As I mentioned, we can run multiple methods in parallel without adding any additional work or any additional runtime. And we've gained portability, reproducibility, and flexibility in our work. So I just have an example of the kind of speed up that we've gotten. And these are just three data sets. They each have 25 images and just varying average number of cells per image in the data set. So for a data set of 25 images of about 10,000 cells in each image, it used to take us 45 minutes just of runtime. And with Nextflow, we've gotten that down to 2.5 minutes, which is fantastic because a lot of times we have to iterate and we'll, you know, change the QC metrics, maybe change which markers we're using to cluster, or remove images potentially based on QC. So this has obviously made our work so much more efficient, and we're really excited because we also are planning to implement on the cloud, which will allow us to scale up to those 10 million cell data sets. And so this is our tentative plan for deploying SpaFlow in the cloud. It is a tentative plan, it's not finalized yet, but we will share it when it's finalized. And I'm by no means the expert, we've been working with a lot of great people on our IT team with this. But the general idea is that researchers will be able to interact with the head node on GCP. They will start the pipeline by pulling in their images from Google Cloud Storage, and then they'll set off the pipeline to be run with Google Batch. And Google Batch will set off all the processes running on worker nodes, and then those worker nodes will write the results back out to Google Cloud Storage. So really excited to see where this goes, and like I said, we'll share the final plan once it's done. As promised, I wanted to share a bit about my experiences as a first timer. So some of my favorite features were the reporting features. It kind of blew me away when I realized that I could get this awesome performance report just by adding with report to my Nextflow run command. So that was really fun. And one thing, just the act of putting my code into Nextflow encouraged me to parameterize my scripts. And so I just feel like this has made me a better programmer in general, because even though that's basic, it's just something that I wasn't very good at doing before, so I appreciate that, which means no more custom scripts for every single project. And the final favorite, and probably my most favorite, is the working directories. Being able to go in and look at what a particular process was doing on one particular sample made debugging so much easier. I could reproduce errors from my colleagues or from myself, and it made development a little less painful. So I just had a couple challenges. Understanding the flow of data between processes and how operators work was a little tough, but there are a ton of great resources out there. And learning Groovy, I was never a Java person, but also luckily, you don't have to be a Groovy expert to write an awesome NextFlow pipeline. So to any fellow beginners, I would say there's a learning curve, but it's totally worth it. And I'm so glad I learned. I wish I had discovered NextFlow so much earlier. So I think you will find that it is worth it. Okay, so I have to acknowledge my amazing collaborators and colleagues at Mayo, especially the members of the DIMI lab led by Dr. Chen Wong, and then the developers of the different packages that I use within NextFlow, Surat, Celesta, and Scimap. So I have all of our repo and website up there. I want to thank you very much for having me, and I appreciate it.
That was deeply relatable. I think that this will have struck a note for many people. And thank you for your message for beginners too, because I think that's really important to hear. And so it's a fantastic testimonial. I had a similar background and coming to code and that sort of thing. So thank you for that. There's a few different questions. We might not have time for all of them. Some of them are a little bit more about the biology of the analysis, really. But I will say there's one question from Rahul. Do you use the same clustering parameters for all data sets? How do you optimize the parameters across tools?
So you can customize in the configurations the clustering parameters for any particular data set. I wouldn't say we have fully figured out how to optimize those for every single data set yet, but it is an iterative process. That's one of the reasons that having it run a lot faster is really important. We do try a number of different clustering resolutions. There's a clustery package that we utilize to kind of try to find the optimal one, but there is still a lot of trial and error in that system.
And I think it's worth saying that the possibility of having configuration files and things like that to be able to run different types of batches of settings and stuff like that really make a difference compared to running things
absolutely manually,
right?
Yes, absolutely.
All right. Thank you so much. This is really great. I am going to call up our next speaker. So thank you very much, Brenna.